Hello everyone, let me introduce myself. My name is Radovan Vojtko and I'm currently the CEO of quantpedia.com. I'm a former quantitative portfolio manager and I have spent over 5 years managing over 300 million euros in several quantitative funds. These funds were focused on multi-asset managed futures and trend following strategies, market timing and volatility trading. In 2015, I took the next big step and became a CEO of Quantpedia. And what's Quantpedia? Quantpedia is a quant research company. Our goal is to turn financial academic research into a more user-friendly form to help anyone interested in quantitative trading. We exist since 2011, and our research covers all main asset classes such as equities, bonds, commodities, currencies, or cryptocurrencies. What do we do? In Quantpedia, we are continually building a database of ideas for quantitative trading strategies, which are extracted out of academic research papers. We read a lot of papers from research portals, financial journals, universities, and select the best and extract performance and risk characteristics and trading rules in plain language. Users can screen our database, learn from research, and look for inspiration. And I'm launching this course exclusively on Quantra's website in collaboration with the Quant Institute team. In this course, you will learn to use academic research to gain an advantage in your trading. We will give you an explanation of one style of trading, seasonal, calendar, event-driven strategies. We will show you several examples of such strategies in different markets. And then we will build one interesting multi-strategy. We will show you how to shield your seasonal strategies in extreme events like coronavirus crisis. And in the end, we will give you tips for additional sources of inspiration so that you can continue growing your knowledge. There are some common questions that are repeatedly asked by people outside of academic research cycles. Where will I get research papers from? Who writes them? Why? And so on. Tens of thousands of research papers related to algo trading and systematic investing are published every year. Most of the research is produced by academia, such as professors and PhDs at universities, but a significant number of papers are published by professionals, such as asset management companies and brokerage houses. Sell-side professionals publish their research freely, or it's sent to their paying clients. And a lot of the research can be easily found via Google or via different special databases such as ssrn.com. Why would somebody publish a working trading strategy? If you are an academic, then it's simple. A lot of academics are curious and they are doing research because that's what they like. They want to show they have bright ideas and they want to let other people know about it. And it's also a way to climb the academic career ladder. And it's possible to increase visibility and start a side business as a consultant for some hedge fund, or they can start a fund on their own. And why asset management companies publish working trading strategies? It's simple, because they want to raise more assets. There was a strong shift in transparency after 2008, and a lot of hedge funds publish a lot of academic research for free to show their expertise. It's a way to gain a trust of pension and sovereign funds and family offices. But once published, will strategy stop working? There are multiple research papers which study this common question, and the consensual answer is no. Strategy usually doesn't vanish. It's less profitable than in the past, and the return to risk ratio is usually lower, but the strategy can still easily be part of the diversified multi-strategy portfolio. It's not so easy to arbitrage market anomalies. Most of the anomalies have time-varying return, and a fair part of the return is preserved as arbitrage is not risk-free. There will never be enough capital to arbitrage all returns away. And how can we use academic research in our trading? We can gain a lot of knowledge out of the research. It will give us understanding of what different types of trading strategies exist and examples of them. And we can gain access to the reasoning of large hedge funds and asset management companies so we can better understand how professionals structure their portfolios. and it will give us ideas for our own strategies. So we can use academic research as an inspiration for development of new investment and trading strategies. So thank you for your attention. And in the following sections, we will together explore one type of trading strategies, seasonal calendar trading. And we will together try to understand economic forces behind. And I hope you will have a lot of fun learning. Thank you.